Oh guys. Today in this video, we are talking about the top 5 countries affected by the outbreak of the COVID-19 virus, by the number of cases. But before starting the video, please don't forget to smash the like, share, and subscribe button. With more than 190 countries confirming the coronavirus cases, and several countries reporting suspected cases, the outbreak has already placed the world on a public health high alert. Wuhan, one of the cities in the Hubei province of China, is the origin of the virus, and the first transmission to humans was in Wuhan in December 2019. Some reports trace the earliest cases back to a seafood and animal market in Wuhan. It may have been from here that SARS-CoV-2 started to spread to humans. When people with COVID-19 breathe out or cough, they expel tiny droplets that contain the virus. These droplets can enter the mouth or nose of someone without the virus, causing an infection to occur. The most common way that this illness spreads is through close contact with someone who has the infection. Close contact is within around 6 feet. The disease is most contagious when a person's symptoms are at their peak. However, someone without symptoms can spread the virus. Droplets containing the virus can also land on nearby surfaces or objects. Other people can pick up the virus by touching these surfaces or objects. Infection is likely if the person then touches their nose, eyes, or mouth. After considering an epidemic for some months, the virus is finally declared as a pandemic by the World Health Organization (WHO) on March 11, 2020. So, here are the top 7 countries that are hugely impacted in terms of confirmed or suspected coronavirus cases. On number 1. United States of America. The number of confirmed coronavirus cases in the US increased significantly in the third week of the March as testing was made more rapid and overtook China's on 26th of March, making the US the world's most affected country by the virus. By the number of cases, the virus escalates from the crowdest place of New York City to the other parts of the country. The first case was confirmed in the United States on January 21st and, according to figures from Johns Hopkins University in Maryland, the U.S. has seen nearly 1.8 million infections and surpassed 105,000 deaths in the COVID-19 pandemic by the end of making this video. On April 12, the U.S. became the nation with the most deaths globally, but there are early signs that the U.S. case and death counts may be leveling off, as the growth of new cases and deaths plateaus. The pattern is inconsistent across the country, as new hotspots emerge and others subside. Besides New York, New Jersey, Illinois, California, and Massachusetts, etc. are the most affected states of the U.S. Though some of the educational institutions are shut down, the country is not in lockdown state, unlike other countries.
Most of the biggest known clusters have been in nursing homes, food processing plants, and correctional facilities, all places where people are packed in close quarters with little opportunity for social distancing. On number 2. Brazil is the part of the ongoing worldwide pandemic of the coronavirus disease, making it the second country to be hugely affected by the virus after the US. The virus was confirmed to have spread to Brazil on February 25, 2020, when a man from Sao Paulo tested positive for the virus. The pandemic has triggered a variety of responses from federal, state, and local governments, having an impact on politics, education, the environment, and the economy. On 27th of March, Brazil announced a temporary ban on foreign air travelers, and most state governors have imposed quarantines to prevent the spread of the virus. If the data of the worldometers.info is to be believed, there are 529,405 confirmed cases and 30,046 people have already lost their lives. On 28th of January, the Ministry of Health, Ministério da Saúde, raised the emergency alert to level 2 of 3, considering an imminent threat for Brazil, as a suspected case was being investigated in Belo Horizonte, Minas Gerais, in a student who had recently visited Wuhan, China, the outbreak's place of origin. On 17th of March, Brazilian authorities partially closed their border with Venezuela. Health Minister Luiz Henrique Mandetta had urged the closure of the border due to Venezuela's collapsing health system. On 23rd of March, the government announced a package of 85.8 billion Brazilian reais for states and municipalities. The amount includes transfers to the health area, recomposition of transfers of constitutional funds, and suspension of the maturity of debts of the states with the union. On number 3. Russia. By the time of making this video, There are 414,878 cases of the coronavirus, from which 4,855 are the total number of deaths. The ratio of the total deaths to the number of confirmed cases is low in Russia. The virus spread to Russia on January 31, 2020, when two Chinese citizens in Yumen, Siberia, and Chita, Russian Far East, tested positive for the virus, with both cases being contained. By the end of March, lockdowns were imposed in the vast majority of federal subjects, including Moscow. By 17th of April, cases were confirmed in all federal subjects. On 27th of April, the number of confirmed cases surpassed those in China. Russia was relatively late in suffering a serious outbreak, but now has become the country with the third most cases in the world, after the United States and Brazil. On 9th of April, Russia passed the 1 million test mark, and in addition to the laboratories of Rospotrebnadzor, 200 state medical laboratories and 22 private laboratories are carrying out testing. On 23rd of January, the Russian city of Blagoveshchensk, near the Chinese border, limited access to the country. Cultural exchange and official visits to China were cancelled. On number 4. Spain.
The ongoing COVID-19 pandemic was first confirmed to have spread to Spain on January 31, 2020, when a German tourist tested positive for SARS-CoV-2 in La Gomera, Canary Islands. The lockdown was imposed on March 14, 2020. On 29th of March, it was announced that beginning the following day, all non-essential workers were ordered to remain at home for the next 14 days. By late March, the community of Madrid has recorded the most cases and deaths in the country. Medical professionals and those who live in retirement homes have experienced especially high infection rates. On 25th of March, the death toll in Spain surpassed that of mainland China, and only Italy's was higher. The number of deaths is also believed to be an underestimate due to lack of testing and reporting, perhaps by as much as 12,000 according to the Spanish Ministry of Health monitoring system on daily excess mortality. As of June 2, 2020, there are 286,718 confirmed cases and 27,127 cases of deaths. On March 10, 2020, the government of Spain decreed the immediate cancellation of all direct flights from Italy to Spain until 25 March. On 12th of March, all traffic between Morocco and Spain was suspended. On number 5. United Kingdom. The COVID-19 pandemic spread to the United Kingdom in late January 2020. In March, London had the highest number of infections, while Northeast England has the highest infection rate. The Department of Health and Social Care launched a public health information campaign to help slow the virus's spread and began posting daily updates in early February. On 31st of January, the first UK cases were confirmed in York. By the end of making this video, there are 276,332 confirmed cases and 39,045 people have already lost their lives. The UK has the highest official death toll in Europe and the second highest in the world. However, the government and many experts say it is too soon to make international comparisons. So, these are the top 5 countries hugely affected by the coronavirus. The number of cases is decreasing in different other countries, like in China, which was the origin of the virus. Different approaches have been followed by various nations to slow down the transmission of the virus to the people. Washing hands with soaps, using sanitizers and face masks, maintaining the distance between people are the safety measures to follow to be safe from the virus. That's all for today. Please like, share, and subscribe to our channel. And what are you doing during this pandemic? Comment down below your answers and stay safe.